Good afternoon, one and all present here. I, Shubham Vankhede, Student Manager, BITM, is honored to introduce our guest speaker, Mr. Ranganath, sir. Sir is from Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh, and did his MBA from Andhra Pradesh University in Personal Management and Industrial Relationship. Sir is a passionate human resource professional, worked with diversified segments like manufacturing, FMCG, ITES, and telecom sector, and also associated with the companies like Asian Paints Limited, Hindustan Coca-Cola Beverages Private Limited, India Cellular Limited, and Aircel Limited. Sir is presently working with Hr-Signode India Ltd. I would like to invite Sir Ranganath sir to on the dais and request him to address the gathering. Thank you.
Here I am today not to give any kind of preach to you guys. Okay? For giving a preaches, for giving a lectures, your professors are there, your lecturers are there. But today I am here to share my experiential validations with you guys, because you're all aspiring young professionals who are ready to getting from campus to corporate. Am I correct? Okay, thank you. Hey boss, I need a lot of responses because as I mentioned to you, it's a very, very interactive session. You can keep disturb me. That doesn't mean that you ask me a lot of questions in between. Definitely, I spare some time for you to answer all your queries, whatever you have. Let me start off. Today's contest is what the subject is, that futuristic trends and changes to business schools, which is very important and inspiring knowledge today, which you are going to talk about. Before starting the contest, I just want to put some kind of thought process in front of you to make the contest more interactive and more able to communicate. Am I able to communicate, guys? Okay. Thank you. Tell me, do you think MS Dhoni is not nervous when he takes the bat and walks into the court? Okay. Do you think PV Sindhu, who won the Olympic medal, is not nervous? Okay. Do you think when the next movie of Amitabh Bachchan releases, when he's seen the success and success and success and the delay of release, he's not going to be nervous, how he's going to do in box office? Not nervous? Sorry, he's also nervous. I'll connect you later. And today, while facing to all you youngsters, all aspiring professionals, am I not nervous? Yes. Oh, you are telling me I'm nervous, but Amitabh Bachchan is not nervous. Okay, thank you. That's fine. Okay. So initially, our nervous system says, can I face? So that is what everybody, every individual always feel, that can I face this kind of situations? So that's normally belonging to the entire individual of the people. But all the people who do it in life, courage is not the absence of fear. It is the ability to go ahead in spite of fear, knowing very well. Do you agree or not? Okay. Wrong action leave me somewhere, but no action leave me nowhere. Do you agree or not? Okay. So please understand, if enemy is inside, something can be done about it. If enemy is inside, nothing can be done about it. In fact, by taking the risk, you are going to lose less. But not taking the risk, you are going to lose more. By setting this contest today, I want to touch upon one of the important aspects of competency. I just want to give a small example to you. At our homes, how many people, how many times we change our housemates? Maybe. Sometimes we keep change our housemates. Correct or not? Do you agree or not? Housemates. Why I'm telling this example, you can relate very easily. Why we change the housemates very frequently? Because the kind of job what she or he performing is not meeting the expectation of us. Correct or not? So that's the only reason we change the our housemates. What does it mean that until unless you demonstrate the right kind of competency at right time, we are nowhere. I'm able to communicate, guys? So that's why the competency will play very, very vital role. I want to share one more example to you. If you go to any electronics retail showroom, okay, we can see Sony TV, Samsung TV, LG TV. Which one you prefer generally? Sony. Why? Because? Why because? Sony, why? Because it's a brand. It's a well-known brand. Lot of features will be there. Whatever you want, the 4K is there. Good colors are there. Everything is there. So why we pick that Sony TV? Because the kind of features are available. You are very happy with the kind of job. You are very happy with the kind of performance of the particular electronic TV. You are buying for that one. So what I'm trying to say here, brand also will determine individual existence in the organization or in the society. By taking that one more example, I want to share with you, how many people know that VUCA world? Achha, you know everything. You know, guys? Okay, absolutely fine. VUCA means, you know, volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. Today's world, today's in the corporate, you are moving from campus to corporate. If you go to any campus to corporate, it's very VUCA world. Nothing is a bed of roses. It's very, very difficult to survive in the organization. That's what I'm sharing with you, some of the colleagues with you. Today, getting a job is not so easy. You know, within a 15 minutes, you could be able to sell your portfolio. You could be able to sell yourself, you will get a job. Getting an employment is not so easy. But employability is which is most difficult in the organizations. So what that needs, what it requires, basically, we can say that knowledge is important, absolutely, and skills are also important, absolutely. But which is one of the most important aspects, which is the attitude. If you don't have the right kind of attitude, how to perform your skill, how to apply your knowledge, and definitely the existence is very difficult. How many people know iceberg theory? I think most of the people know iceberg theory. So tip of the iceberg, if you can see only tip of the iceberg, that means if you want to interact with any person, you can able to understand his knowledge and skills. But you don't know what's the kind of attitude he's behaving, how he's behaving, what kind of thoughts is he having in mind, which is very difficult to understand the individual attitude. That's the reason, friends, if one should have the right kind of attitude to get the success into any of the organization. I want to tell you one more good example to you guys. You know, how many stages of life? How many stages of life we have? Yeah, 7 stages of life we have. And we all know that the 7 stages of life is that infancy, childhood, adolescence, teenage, middle age, early old age, later old age. Tell me one thing. I want to just correlate here the competency with the 7 stages of life. Guys, why I'm insisting competency every time? Because unless you have the right kind of competency, we are nowhere. Our existence is very less. Our existence will be very difficult. So you as a child, you have to show certain kind of competencies while convincing your mother, while convincing your father or brothers and sister. Once you come across from childhood to and again adolescence, it's again the same kind of competencies will not work at all. Because what I'm trying to say here, competency never remains same. Competencies keep changing, depends on the situation, depends on the society, which kind of people are interacting, what kind of society you are in there. So competency always build individual personification. Okay, if you demonstrate the same kind of competency when you are a childhood, in adolescence, it is very difficult. Do you agree or not? So what I am trying to say, the competencies will keep changing individuals and you need to upgrade your competencies. Competency may be functional competency or maybe behavioral competency. Both will have to hand in hand together, he has to journey. Until unless we have the both competencies in right balanced way, it's again very, very difficult for us to exist in the society or a personal life. So to take this forward, I don't know how many people know the story of Surat diamond merchant story. Anybody know? No, anybody knows that? Okay, fine. I just want to touch upon here. Surat normally, basically Surat is one of the famous for all diamonds. There is a guy called Sivaji, is one of the top diamond merchant in Surat. Okay? He has a son by name Dravya, 21 years old. He has a Stanford graduate, and he told his son, "Beta, you just completed the graduation from Stanford University. Now I need your help in the business. Okay? Definitely you have to take some of my responsibilities." He said, "Yes, Papa, I'm ready to take up your responsibilities." You know what will happen at the time? The father, what he said, "I don't want to give responsibilities at this point of time. First, you should learn how the society is looking like. And you should know how to live in the society." You know, guys, what he did? He sent his son for 21 days with only 7,000 rupees. He is from Surat. He told very clearly, "You should not use my name. You should not use any family name. You have to stay with where you don't know the language also." You know, he traveled from Surat to Cochin. You know, Cochin is a typical Malayalam where they don't speak much of Hindi. Okay? He just left the home with only 7,000 rupees and he worked in such a kind of small, in a McDonald's, in a coffee shop, and in a shoe shop for 21 days. He understands how life it is. After completion of 30 days of spending with a different kinds of thing, he reached father and he told, "Papa, world is not so easy, what I'm thinking, because this Stanford is a million crore son, you know." But father said that, so that is what life. So until unless you should know the right kind of values in life, up to upbringing the so kind of values, how we need to interrelate with the corporate, it's very difficult to survive. So then after spending that much of time, and father has given the responsibility to son, now he's doing very well. Why I told this story? Because one should have the values in life, guys. Maybe you may be thinking that why this guy is telling all these things. I just want to share one of my experiential validation to you so that you can relate well. When I was 17 years old, I just completed my intermediate. Okay? I'm not from business schools like you guys. I don't have such kind of facilities. We have a combined study, group of my classmates. I used to come to my house and do all mathematics. I'm an MPC graduate, math, physics, chemistry kind of thing. You know, results are out, but I got less marks from my, compared to all other my classmates. Believe me, I felt a little bit embarrassed because all these people are coming to my home and we are learning, but I could not able to score well compared to others. Then, believe me, what I did, you know, guys? I ran away from my house. From Visakhapatnam to, I moved to Hyderabad. What intentions are there in my mind? Because I felt very little bit guilty to show my face to my father, because he's always expecting my son should have good score, good marks. Of course, any father, mother will always expect such kind of thing. So after reaching Hyderabad, believe me, guys, I stayed in railway station for 1 week. Only railway station, having bath, reading newspaper, watching TV kind of thing. After spending 4 days, I really felt myself, this is the life I want to lead in my life. So this is what I'm struggling for, that my existence. I realized myself, I introspected myself. On 5th day, again, I moved back from Hyderabad to Visakhapatnam. When I reached my house, because my father is a finance head in Dredging Corporation of India, the entire house office is full of police people, all relatives, everybody is there. You know, because they're searching for me since last 5 days. Because at the time, this much of social networking, nothing is there. They're about to put in a newspaper to search for me. So what was happened when I reached my home? So my house full of police and house full of all relatives kind of thing. You know, good thing happened, guys. When I entered into my home, my father told, I have two younger brothers and my mother, please don't ask him where he went, what he did for all these 5 days. Let him feel whenever he says from his mouth, then only you have to listen. But don't ask anything. I listened from that word from my father's mouth. I really felt, he don't want to unnecessarily defaming my name, defaming me in front of all other people, all other my relatives and everybody. Till today, guys, my father or mother never asked me where you went all these 4 days or 5 days. Why I'm telling you all these things again? So unless you introspect ourselves in life, where do you want to achieve? What is your ultimate goal? Believe me, on that day, the 4 days, 5 days of stay at railway station made me to think myself, I want to work in a big companies. I want to look in a branding companies. That made me today, I work in a company called Asian Paints, Coca-Cola India, Idea Cellular, Aircel, Bank of America, and Signode. Guys, I'm proud to say that out of 10 TV holdings, four TV advertisements belongs to my company. I feel very proud. If I travel across any highway, out of 10 holdings, 4 holdings to belongs to my companies. I feel very proud. Why I'm telling you guys? Because why I have shared this experience? Because always sharing the realistic experience will make you to relate more. I don't want to share, something has happened. I want to collate with you all kind of thing. Because if I share the realistic experience, that really determines one individual's how we need to get the success in life. So what I'm trying to say here, one should have the real passion in the organization, real passion in the individual. If you have the passion, if you have the courage, you can do definitely anything. As I mentioned to you in my first contest, one should have the courage in life. I want to get into, I should be very passionate to lead my life so that then only we can share the success of life. Okay? By saying that, why I'm telling every time, self has to realize, self has to realize. Guys, you are all business students. You are upcoming professionals. Now tomorrow you are going to lead different functions like HR, finance, marketing, operations. You should have the right kind of attitude, right kind of thought process in you. So that, believe me, again I'm telling you, you're all young generations. Correct or not? You are Gen Y? Are you Gen Y? Yes, great. So, you're all Gen Y, Generation Y. You guys are having a lot of aspirations. Correct or not? Your dreams are very big. You have a lot of thought process. You want to get a success instantly. You want to get appreciation instantly. Is it really possible in the VUCA world? Not possible. Okay? For that reason, what you need to do, you have to build your own competence. How to manage the Gen X. Who is the Gen X? Like us. Maybe I'm not good at right now. But still, the gray hair people, you have to manage the gray hair people in any organization. Irrespective of any segment you talk about, whether it is a manufacturing, whether it is a telecom, whether it is a IT, whether it is ITS, infrastructure, wherever you go, you have gray hair people will be there. You have to manage, you have to understand, you have to learn from the Gen X, those kind of thought process, so that you could able to build the right kind of foundation, then you get the right kind of success. Why I'm telling you guys, one more example I share with you. I've been to a lot of campuses because I started my career in Asian Paints. The first 2 years, I went to all campuses. You talk about any IIT from south to north, any IIM, all kind of all areas. But only one thing I want to tell here, how many people got success after hiring to the organizations? Believe me, guys, because I'm very passionate, as I said you, I want to candid sharing with you. I don't want to, admire you kind of thing. Because of I being head of HR, tomorrow you are going to come and face most of the HR folks. The next few months, you must have this kind of intensity, this kind of intuition in your mind, then you definitely will get success. So, what I'm trying to say here, if you have the so-called right kind of competence we have, if you keep upgrading your competence as per the requirement of the organization, as per the requirement of the individual, definitely you feel a lot of success and a lot of enthusiasm and a kind of thing. See, most of the thing, what will happen, most of the Gen Y people, sorry to say that, they're not able to stick on to the organizations. Why? Because the attrition is very high. Why? Come on, guys. The attrition of younger generation is very high. Why? Absolutely. Sorry? Yeah, yes, absolutely. See, you have high aspirations. You have instant aspirations. Absolutely, one should have the high aspiration. That doesn't mean that you have to challenge the status quo, which is also most important. Because unless you have the ground realities, until unless you have the right kind of subject thought process, it is very difficult to again survive in the so-called organization. And one more thing, most of the time what's happening, because of you, people are having a lot of aspirations, you are giving up very easily. Guys, 10 years back, if somebody wants to quit the organization, he or she has to think 10 times, what kind of organizations I'm going to, what's the kind of existence will be there in the particular organization, whether am I able to adjust in the organization. So this kind of thought process is required before if you want to leave the organization 10 years back. Today's context, what's happening? If any kind of rift is happening, if any kind of small differences coming between the manager and you, manager and employer, immediately you're giving up, you're putting down resignation, saying that, yes, I want to quit the company. What reason? I'm not gelling with you. I'm not cope up with you. I'm not satisfied here. So these are the basic, these are very, very vague kind of answers we are getting from the so-called, you know, younger generations. So without having any job in hand, they're really quitting because of they have confidence. Yes, of course. If you ask me in exit interview, why you are quitting in a third party, normally we do third party exit interviews, why you left? Then people used to say, I'm not happy with my manager. I'm not happy with the kind of work I'm assigning to me. So that's why I'm leaving. But without job in hand, how are you managing? Yes, I'm a confident, I want to get a job. I will get a job over a period of time. So what is happening here? He's getting a job. But again, because of desperation, he's joining to some other company where he needs money. But that company is really getting into right kind of track, a right kind of pathway, right kind of success. He's not thinking because he wants a job, he or she wants a job, immediately getting a job. So that what happens here, the entire career planning will get a lot of disturbances. Guys, I want to share one more truth. Most of the IITians and most of the some of the people, they're giving up their jobs in a middle way. And a lot of suicide cases. I don't know how many people understand, how many people are reading nowadays. A lot of suicidal cases are happening in the organization because of the lot of tremendous pressure is there. They're not able to manage the aspirations and reality. Am I able to connect you guys? One should have aspiration, but what is the reality? Which also need to understand. For that only you need a competence. I need to understand the reality. I need such kind of competency. You know, that makes a lot of difference because the rift between aspiration and the reality, not able to cope up. What's happening end of the day? I'm quitting. I'm giving up. I'm thinking that my life is nothing. So guys, understand, I'm always tell competence, competence, competence. Having a right kind of competence definitely will lead you different kinds of things. Again, one more point I want to touch upon here. In today's corporate world, nothing is stable. Maybe you are from HR, or from finance, or from marketing. Everyone should know everything. Otherwise, very difficult to manage again. Even HR guys, I want to tell you one example again. I being HR guy, I'm a senior manager HR in Idea Scheduler. I roam across each and every retailer, every distributor. I want to understand who is my customers. What is shop in shop? How many people know what is shop in shop? Anybody, any idea? What is shop in shop? Any marketing folks? Hey guys, shop in shop, you don't know. I'm so sorry to hear like this. Guys, you must know what today, one of the most happening thing is shop in shop. If you go to more, or if you go to any kind of mall, the first and foremost you go to, the small cubicles will be there. Lakme, L'Oreal, in a big mall, their small shop will be there. Correct or not? That is called shop in shop, guys. Understand? That's why I said basics are most important. Somebody saying stop or stop is a foolish. Sorry, guys. Shop or stop is nothing but shop in shop. That means instead of keeping a big space, instead of renting so many things, instead of hiring so many people, we can keep the small kiosk in shop in shop. Correct or not? How many people know about purchase intent? PI. Guys, I'm surprising. I'm expecting so many things from you. I'm disappointed. What is PI? Purchase intent. No idea? Purchase intent. I'll give you an example. For example, you want to go for a provision. You want to buy a provision. Sorry? Okay. You want to go to buy a provision. You go to one mall. Your expectation is around 5,000. Your budget is only 5,000 or 6,000 rupees. But end of the day, you end up with what? End up with what? 8,000, 9,000 may be difference on your financial background. That means, whatever you see, to ankom se that kya dekhte ho, even though you're not planned, you want to buy that. Correct or not? Guys, I'm able to communicate. Even though you're not planned to buy something, but the moment you go to mall, you intend to buy. So that is called purchase intent. Okay? So PA is most important. That's why the most of the malls, if you can say, whichever is very easy to attract, the moment you go to any kind of mall, big malls, immediately you can see, for example, after speaking to me, after talking to me, then if you go to any mall, you experience all these words. What is shop in shop? What is purchase intent? All kind of things you would be able to experience. Until unless we know the market reality, what is going on the market, and we don't know the end customer. I being a HR guy, I should know what is my end customer. Believe me, I want to give one example here, if you have patience. When I'm working for Airtel, I worked in Airtel. After completion of my 8 years in manufacturing, after Asian Paints and Coca-Cola, I joined in company Airtel, which is in Bangalore. You know, guys, it is absolutely paradigm shift. In manufacturing, from security to till the everybody gets salute. In the shop floor, if you walk across, everybody says salute, sar, bolke. If you go to telecom, which is service segment, absolutely paradigm shift. Lot of expectations from HR. They don't bother about it at all. Their expectations very high. If I hit the entire the call center people, there are 300, 400 call center executives are sitting there. What I'm trying to say here, again, I'll go back to my competence. If I could able to demonstrate those manufacturing kind of competencies, my existence in telecom is very difficult. I can't survive in telecom because their speed of execution is important, operational excellence is important, and speed is most important. So until unless I exhibit these kind of qualities, it's very difficult for me to survive in the telecom industry. So in the same way, if anybody move from one segment to another segment, if irrespective of any function you are, whether it's a finance or HR or marketing or sales, whatever it may be, the basic principles are same. Do you agree, guys? Agree or not? If any HR function you see, entry to exit, talent acquisition, talent management, employee engagement, and talent management. See, both are common to all segments. Whichever segment you go, all are common. But what makes difference, how we are able to exhibit those kind of things will determine. The people are different. The aspirations are different. The expectations from the people are different. Why I'm telling you this guy, I want to give a small example here. See, when I'm working for Airtel Bangalore, I was in Hyderabad. I was working in Bangalore. You know, we used to work in a weekly 5 days. One fine day, one of my CSD head came to me, Ranga, we have to hire 30 call center executives. They want to be on board by Monday. You know, Friday, 5 o'clock, he came to me and he said that he has to hire 30 call center executives by Monday. That means only 2 day gap is there. I could outrightly reject, boss, sorry, boss, not possible. Correct or not? Do you agree or not? I booked my ticket to Hyderabad to travel from Bangalore to Hyderabad because of weekend. But he said that your VP HR also accept. Boss, am I able to communicate or am I distracted? Okay, thank you. So, I can say, outrightly I can say, sorry boss, not possible, I booked my ticket, I want to go to Hyderabad. But he said one more point. Ranga, your VP HR also accepted, we have to hire 30 call center executives by Monday. It's a very, very high pressure. How do I hire 30 people? That means, if I want to onboard 30 people, minimum I have to interview 300 candidates. Do you agree or not? 10 is 3, 1 is 10. So in that situation, what happened? So it's very difficult to manage. And again, one thought has come into mind, you know, paper leaflets, small kind of leaflets. I used to stay in Jayanagar and JP Nagar. I made a lot of prints of paper leaflets, the inserts into the paper, and it went into all the Jayanagar and JP Nagar, other MG Road, all other places. Early morning, 5 o'clock, I woke up. I ensured that the paper leaflets gone inside and reached to the all households, all the people. Believe me, guys, on Saturday, if I go to our Airtel office, there are 100 to 200 people are getting into queue to get in a registration of the recruitment. So what I'm trying to say here, again, why I'm giving a realistic example, you would be able to understand what kind of VUCA world uncertainty, ambiguity will be there. See, nothing is a rose of birds. Everything is a challenge. We have to challenge the status quo. Until unless you have to challenge the status quo, it's very difficult. One more important point I want to touch here. What is meant by performance? Any idea? Generic ID, I'm asking you. Performance what? Performance is what, man? Sorry? To complete one task. To complete the given task. Is it performance? Correct or not? What is meant by potential? What is the potential? Sorry? Ability to? Absolutely. Very good. See, there is always huge difference between the performance and potential. Why I'm telling you, the guys, if you're going to corporate to campus, campus to corporate, you always encounter this. I'm a good performer, but I'm not getting promotion. I'm a good performer, I'm not getting the right kind of increment. But there is, as I mentioned to you, there is a huge difference between the performance and potential. Until, unless, see, he may be a good, he or she may be a good performer. He is getting a good rating out of 1 to 5 rating, 5 is excellent. Consistently, last 3 years, he is getting rating 5, he is getting a good increment. Is he promotable? Is there any guarantee to promote him because of his getting 5 rating, which is excellent since last consecutively 3 years? So, no. Why? Because he is always thinking, he is never come back, he never come out of the out-of-box thinking. He is always comfort. He is having a small grid. These are my KRAs, key result areas. I accomplished my all my KRAs. I given my 100% shot. I want to get my increment right way. That's what he will do. But he always also creep into, I'm not getting promotion even though I got good ratings in the last 3 years. So what company is looking today here? Potential is important. You should have the right kind of potential. Until, unless you have the right kind of potential, out of box thinking, moving out of the comfort zone. How many people, see, for example, again I'm telling you guys, if any MT joined, he was from Mumbai, if I place him to Cochin, immediately he want to quit. Why? Because, sir, I'm from West, I don't want to go to South. So, the potential, potential also is very much, very, very, very important if you really want to get into a success in the organization. So, by saying all these things, as I mentioned to you since beginning, the competencies will play a very vital role, which is number one. Number two, preparation is also important. How many people are agree preparation is so important? Preparation means, it's very, very, today, most of the folks are thinking that I know everything. I have all knowledge. I have Google, I have lab, I have iPod, everything is there. But until, unless you prepared properly on what kind of review you are going to, and what kind of business review or what kind of meeting you are going to have, until unless you have prepared your points, it's very difficult for you to get in the room. If you're not able to prepare, you're out of the contest. You're not able to answer anything. Do you agree or not? Guys, do you agree or not? So why I'm telling you, why I'm in, but please believe me, these things maybe you know everything, but this is a requirement in the organization. If I call for 2 executives for a meeting, they simply come walk across by 9 o'clock. What were they walked in, they don't know. What is their preparation, they don't know. So you should know how to prepare, what is the most important, the kind of thing. And again, planning for self. Planning for self is also most important. I know, out of this room, out of this block, 50% of the people think that, what this bloody guy is telling all these things, as if we don't know anything. But guys, this is only the missing in the organizations. We're always seeing any exit interview, any kind of performance reviews, any kind of succession planning, any kind of career planning, people are not able to demonstrate what I'm trying to say right now to you. Okay? So again, self-discipline is most important. Of course, self-investment is also the most important. Because over a period of time, once you get a MBA grads, okay, we are getting a job in the organizations. How many people really want to invest on themselves? Until unless I keep upgrade myself based on the requirement of the organization or a functional kind of thing, it is again very difficult for me to survive in the organizations. And again, eye for details, which is again most important. We should have the right kind of eye for details. Hey guys, again I'm telling you, if out of 10 MTs, if I want to keep 5 MTs in a top territories, metros, what kind of people I'm looking at? I need a guy with who are eye for details. I need a guy who is self-disciplined. I need a guy who is planning. I need a guy who is preparing. But you may be getting 90%, but he's getting 60%. I don't bother about it. But the guy who is the right kind of ability, right kind of attitude, right kind of thought process, those people will definitely get the success other than the 80%, 90% who is getting. Do you agree or not? So this is a reality, guys. What I'm today till now, what I'm sharing with you, these are all experiential validations. I'm not exaggerating anything. The point blank I'm telling to you. So these are the kind of experiential validations which I'm sharing with you, which are more and most important if you really want to get success in any good corporate when moving from corporate campus to corporate. And one more important point I want to touch upon before closing that. How many people know will and skill game? Will and skill. Okay. Of course, not a game. Okay. If you have a good skill, but if you don't have will to do, what will happen? Correct or not? So will and skill is always a balanced approach. Until unless you have the right kind of will and right kind of skill, when you need to apply, if you don't know, it's again very difficult to success in the corporates. How many people know T-skilling? Any HR folks are here? T-skilling, no? Anybody know? T-skilling? What is T-skilling? T-skilling is nothing but T, you know, the T, capital T, horizontal and vertical. Okay? If anybody want to grow, not only growing always in a vertical kind of thing. There is always opportunity to grow in a horizontal also. So people should always be ready with the T-skilling approach with horizontal or vertical kind of thing. And also, before closing my this session, I want to give my one of the best example. Maybe people boring, but I'll stop. Don't worry. How many people like movies here? Wow, great. Okay, I'm a big movie buff. I love watching movies. Why I watch movies? I'll tell you one year. What is the revenue of Bahubali? What is the revenue of Bahubali? Absolutely, 2,000 crores. You know, if you really want to have any business, so-called, you know, MNCs, MNC companies, MNC big corporates, even their revenues also may be 1,000 crores, 1,500 crores, 2,000 crores, correct? Do you agree or not? I just want to share with you how to make a movie versus corporate world. I'll give you some kind of rationale to you. Maybe you may be interesting. Making a movie, you know, it's not so easy. From the light boy to the production manager has to sync everything. Getting a Amitabh Bachchan on sets is not so easy. The production manager has to ensure that which driver is going to pick him up, which car is going to pick him up, who are the co-artists should be ready in the sets, what is the kind of logistics you need to support, everything, because Amitabh Bachchan call sheet is very costly. Do you agree, guys, or not? In the corporate world, so-called corporate world, if you want to plan one execution meeting, if you want to plan one engagement, employee engagement, if you want to have some kind of, you know, any kind of general body meetings, what will happen? Some guy will push, some guy will pull. Do you agree or not? But in corporate, we have IIMs, so-called IIMs. We have so-called IITNs. We have so-called business grads. We have so-called so many people. Do you agree or not? Whereas, in the movie making, the light boy who don't know anything, he just only switch on, switch off light. Okay? And the kind of co-artist, the choreographer, the photographer, everything, believe me guys, absolute tick-tock. That means the kind of commitment, the kind of passion, the kind of determination, the kind of sankalp they have in their mind, we don't have in so-called corporates. I'm sorry to say, guys. Do you agree or not? The producer knows when my movie is going to release. Can anybody can say after 10 days, what is going to happen to your life? Do you agree or not? The producer should know when his movie is going to release, when his movie is going to certification, the kind of logistic support. Guys, if they want to, entire crew want to go to Australia, entire crew want to go to US, it is not so easy. It needs a lot of commitment. It needs a lot of understanding. Today, if you want to travel from Mumbai to Pune, we get a lot of glitches. A bus nahi, a tick nahi, wo tick nahi kind of thing. Why I'm telling all these things? The kind of the set of competencies they are demonstrating at the right time to see the success of the movie. How much of inputs gone for Bahubali in the Rajamouli? You know that? What kind of thought process gone into mind? And again, one more thing I want to tell you guys. If any artist, for example, take a Shah Rukh Khan or Salman Khan, they want to come to sets early morning 4 o'clock. Understand, guys? Please concentrate. Early morning, or Sonam Kapoor, she has to come to early morning 4 o'clock on the set. Even if she has a problem at home, she can't show their emotions on her face. Do you agree, guys, or not? But today, tell me, in the so-called corporate, if I want to ask my team member, hey boss, you have to come for tomorrow, Saturday normally off, na? You have to come to Saturday some work, he or she will tell 100 reasons why she can't come to office on Saturday. Do you agree or not? I don't know, am I able to relate? What I'm trying to say, the stretching, moving out of the comfort, taking additional responsibility, challenging the status quo, making self-emotions. As I mentioned to you, if Sonam Kapoor would show their emotions on the set, the entire set will collapse. The entire call sheet will go on for a toss. The co-artist will go on for a toss. Producer will become a big loss. Will it be acceptable? Not at all. You know, they sign the agreement. Every call sheet, they sign the agreement. It is not so easy, guys. That's why I'm just want to relate to you, all you guys. The kind of commitment, the kind of passion they show, which is really missing in the current corporate world. So guys, if you really want to get a success, the passion makes you some different leaps and bounds. If you have the right kind of passion, the right kind of attitude, yes, success always come on your feet. But if you feel that I have everything in my life, then it's very difficult to get a survive in the any kind of, whether it is a life, whether it is a personal life, whether it is a social life, whether it is a corporate. I just want to close this my session with this kind of inputs. I wish you all the very best for your aspiring young Gen Y professionals. Okay, guys, please believe me, please make you understand whatever I said to you today. I told you, definitely you will experience 100%. I'll give in writing to you guys. Okay, guys, so my sincere, my humble request to all of you, please have the right kind of attitude. Believe me, guys, today's session, maybe August 12th, I'm telling you guys, if you demonstrate, if you keep upgrading your right kind of competencies, as a husband, I have to demonstrate one competencies. As a wife, she has to demonstrate competencies. As a mother, as a brother, as a lover, everything is a competency. Guys, why I'm not happy? Because of I'm not liking the what she do. Correct or not? Do you agree or not? So competence will always play very, very vital role in individual lives. So with this note, I would like to end up this session. Thank you very much for giving this session. Again, Mr. Saha and Mr. Beluri, entire Balaji Institute of Management Studies, my grateful thanks to you, all of you guys, for sparing this time with me and listening to me with a lot of patience. Again, guys, patience is also one of the most important aspects. If you have patience, until unless you gain patience, we'll lose the game. We're all playing a game. Okay. Thank you so much, guys, for a wonderful session.
I, student manager Darshna Nagdev, express my profound gratitude to our guest, Mr. IVS Ranganath sir. The most beautiful thing in creation of a child are his mistakes. The more the child's work is full of these individual mistakes, the more wonderful it is. And the more a teacher removes them from the child's work, more desolate and impersonal it becomes. I thank you, sir, for your efforts in highlighting words. It's really beneficial for us. As you said, competency always builds individual personalities. Planning and investing for ourselves is very important in shaping our career. Now, I finally would like to take this opportunity to place on record a hearty thanks to our beloved Bala sir for his guidance and providing us such a stimulating environment. Thank you.